What are we talking about? Just the game tomorrow? I'm gonna tell DJ Mike Scott to grab me one. That's who Dalton's going with Mike Scott, right? Hey, you got another seltzer?
Do you want to grab? Do you want to grab this one? I'll put Cody and Marquette over here.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Cody. It's not going to be the least restricted in the road.
Every time I listen to Brandon's name,
what's up, Raider Nation? Hey, should I sit back like this? I feel cool like this, though.
That's nice.
What y'all mean? What are we talking about in this segment? Where my other glass of wine at? I'm gonna at least.
How many in there?
If I don't get picked up by another. If I don't get picked up by a team this year, dog, can I come back again? Just be a guest? Shit.
He gonna be on the Saints, bro. Our punter's trash.
Who, the Saints? Oh, Lou Haley tripping like that?
He been terrible, bro.
We actually reached out. I actually reached out to him.
Yeah, he's been booting like 29 yarders, dog. Like,
just throw an interception.
Dude, brutal.
That's what I told my coach in the XFL. I was like, bro, instead of having me punt, just tell the quarterback to just lob it in the air because some young ass DB going to be happy to get a pick.
Yeah,
like, I got to get the pick, man. It's part of my stand. Tackle.
Oh, you click off. I was like, AJ, halftime? He said, hell no. Am I supposed to say?
Yo, welcome back to the Oak Las Vegas Raiders Network. I got my family in the building. We're going to have some fun today, you guys. A quick pod. You know what I mean? I got my guys in town. We are doing our blackout experience in Las Vegas. We are at the Blue Wire Studios right now. When? I got my brother B in the building. I got Cody in the building. We just got off a fresh pod.
Yo,
right?
Yo.
Got my brother Hammer in the building on the other side. And we got our brother Marquette King in the building behind us over here, man. And we have our brother Barco Cody. This is actually special because we don't really get to do this a lot. The draft was fun, though.
The draft was fun.
We got Cody squared in the building.
But salute, man. This is just a quick live show, you guys. Wanted to get the chat involved. You guys have any questions for anybody over here, let us know what it is, man. We just interviewed our brother Marquette King. It will be up shortly on the Blackout Division on YouTube, so make sure you guys check that out. What's good, man? What are we doing today, Cody?
We're going to get into a lot of nonsense, a lot of shit. Probably. Yeah. I'm running. I've been up since 3:30 in the morning.
Fumes.
And, yeah, we have too many events planned.
Yeah.
I didn't really think it through.
So right here, we're kicking it with all the fam, and then after this, we're going to
Daylight Beach.
Doing it too short. Oh, my God.
We're going to see Too Short for Too Long.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. Definitely. Yeah.
We're going to be blacked out by the blackout
party. By the blackout party. And so if anyone is in the Vegas area, you guys, today, man, just a heads up, we'll be at Daylight for the Too Short party. Then we are going to Tropicana where we do our legendary blackout parties. What is this night? 7 p.m. to 11 p.m.?
7 to 12.
7 to 12. Okay, yep. We got an extra hour. So be there. Marquette's going to be there kicking the wood us today. We're going to be vibing out, man. So make sure if you're in the Vegas area, you guys, hit us up, man. Follow me. We're about to be having a ball. And well, we got a party bus tomorrow, too, right?
We got a party bus. That's a burger boy over here.
Yeah. Burger boy, man. Hey, real quick, everybody in the chat, man, put your questions in. If you have one for Marquette, anybody else, man. And I want to do this real quick, too, man. I don't really like to plug a lot of my stuff, but I got somebody here. You guys get a chance to, man. Barco Burgers. Go to Barco Burgers. I'm telling y'all right now, my favorite spot. And I'm not even saying that because it's family. I literally jumped off the plane, caught a lift, and went to Barco. You weren't even there yesterday.
Yeah, you and Hammer.
Yeah, straight up and went over there.
Hold
and got
on, bro. I tried to get the legendary hangover burger. Yeah, I'm telling you.
I'm actually right mad back. I couldn't get there today. That's usually my routine. Come into town, get a burger, get my mindset right, and then get on my weekend.
I had to get my snooki on and get those fried pickles, man. That's where it's at. Every single time I come to Vegas, I got to hit up Barco.
Southern fried, bro. The pickles is different.
Hey, Kat, I want to ask you a question, right?
Mm-hmm.
We were just kind of talking behind the scenes. Hey, these punters, man, right?
Yeah.
Are they spoiled when they're kicking indoors?
Of course, man. Hey, look. I'm going to tell y'all this, man. Look, if I played indoors, man, my numbers would be way different because – even over half of the season, punters be playing indoors, so like they ain't got to worry about wind, wet temperature, nothing. They got 8 perfect games to play in, so they definitely spoil when they play indoors.
So basically, if you were still a Raider, you'd just be dog walking shit.
I'd be doing a lot of stuff out here, man. It's Vegas.
Yo, hey Cody, what we got going on at Daylight, man? I know so. Cody is the guy to know in Vegas, man. Like, if anyone is blacked out drunk, they're probably right next to Cody. Because I know every time I woke up and didn't know what the hell was going on, I knew that Cody was around 2:40. And we're talking about Barco Cody, right? Not Raider Cody, too. We're always slapped out together as well. But well, what do we got going on over there, man?
Yeah, we got a little situation.
Lituation.
Actually kept it pretty low key, but we have the bungalow. So we're going to have the biggest cabana in Daylight. We're going to be right next to the stage.
Wait, is that for sure?
Oh, it's locked in. I didn't want to pump you up too much.
Held that secret in yesterday. We were having that conversation, and I'm just like, wait, what?
Yeah.
He's like, I'll find out in the morning. I'm like, oh, great. This is going to be fun. Up.
Locked in. So we're going to be dialed in, boys. It's going to be a good time.
It's a Raider, like a whole Raider party? Like
it can be.
Don't be.
We'll probably turn it into it.
Bring a football out there. I just start punting. Let's go. I need my practice.
Start hitting people in the head in the pool.
No, just aim for the pool. I'll try to dive into one.
Yo, salute, man. The top beats. He says,
how about the pool start running the football back?
He said, Barco Burgers is the best burger in town, man. Salute to my guy, Top Beats. And shout out to LV. He's always at Barcode as well. You guys, if you're in the area, man, make sure you pull up, man. Hammer, man, what we got going on, man? What's up, man? What did we do last night? We hung out with Chuck. So Mitch is supposed to be here as well. Yeah. He ran off. He is struggling mightily right now. and he has a new name. Ket. What is Mitch's new name?
Man, I'm still trying to bait. Like, I was going to call him Captain America because he got the part in his head.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It's clean. But, like, I feel like we should call him Captain World Team.
There he is. Right on cue, bro.
He's in the window right now. I love it. Salute to our brother Mitch, man. Maybe we'll get him in here in a second as well. If not, you'll see him on the Blackout Pod. So
yep.
It is what it is. Hey, man, let everybody know, Cody, man, these Blackout parties, what can they expect? Man, we got DJ. Come on, man. Mike is the best DJ in town.
Yes, sir. You know yeah, Mike Scott always holds it down.
My dog, my brother, man.
Every event, really. I mean, tailgate party, night before party, whatever it is to make it happen. I mean, it's all about vibes. Clearly starts with Mike Scott. I think it starts with all the people in attendance, too. You know what I mean? We have a really cool group. It could just be us six hanging out at a Blackout party. We're going to have a good time.
Yeah.
But clearly, I think we already have too many RSVPs for our capacity. So tomorrow's also going to be – or tonight's going to be messy on that end. But we got a full party bus. Man, we're going to have a packed-out tailgate. It's just, you know, home opener weekend's always huge. Yeah. I'm hyped. We're all hyped. Feels good. It's weird. It's week three.
Yeah.
That it took us for to get a home game, but, man, it's –
playoff atmosphere, for real.
Yeah,
playoff prices.
Prices too. Sure. Prices too.
But who would have thought this is a must win week three?
Yeah. I mean, I don't want to say I got our best case scenario, but I just didn't want to be 0-2 going into week three.
Yeah.
I'm sitting here like, you know, beginning of the season, I'm content if we go 1-1. Yeah. I didn't expect to get Buffalo. I didn't expect to get got by Buffalo like we did, but we're still 1-1, fresh start. And we'll see. Maybe throw the ball around a little bit more or something. I don't know.
Yeah, man. How you calling this tomorrow, Cody? What you got? Hey, be realistic, bro. Like, what?
Raiders are favorite, bro. Like 2.5 right now.
Yeah.
And Sunday night football is different. Yeah. Like the one I went to was the Chargers Sunday night. That game was electric. Yeah. So I expect the Raiders to bring the heat, man. Steelers ain't looking that hot too. So
yeah.
Hey, how you guys liking your new quarterback over there in New Orleans right now?
Oh, big DC guy.
Yeah, former Ket.
Yes, sir.
Teammate.
That's my guy, man.
Yeah, man. Hey, how you feeling over there thus far?
I feel good, 2-0, and he's got a defense behind him.
Yeah,
you know, he's just hankering it down. Just don't turn the ball over, and just keep getting dubs.
Bro, he actually looks really good in that uniform too, though.
No, oh, he's swaggy,
he
dude.
He looks swaggy.
Hurts my soul, man.
That first intro in the dome was electric.
Talking about the video?
Oh yeah, bro.
Yeah, bro.
Car knows how to get those shots, man.
But what's going on, Cody? Like, you know,
like, man,
the red zone issues, man, is still dealing with some red zone issues. Man. You know, I gotta, you know,
hey,
I gotta,
we're new
I gotta,
to this.
Hey, look,
I gotta break your balls.
Look, it was always about winning, and he's 2-0.
There you go.
That's all I got. I don't
basically
know.
If we would have had a great defense this whole time, we'd have won a lot of games.
You know, look, man, he's gonna go out there and he's gonna do his job. I do really wish, I mean, DC's my guy, love him as a person, always. Really wish Raider Nation would let it go a little bit. It's like I feel like every game day I'm firing up on social media. It's all I still read about is Derek Carr. I'm like, man, I thought finally, finally we weren't going to have to deal with this no more. But, you know, hey, it is what it is. And, you know, fans going to be fans. But hopefully at one point, you know, we get this team on track to where we have more to talk about besides Chandler Jones.
I know Ket kind of removed from, like, what's going on with the NFL right now. But I know you kind of see what's going on with the Chandler
Jones. I can pick up on vibes really well.
Yeah.
So, like, what you want to know?
Like the Chandler Jones situation right now, right? Like, I know a few guys, former football players, that deal with, you know, mental health and stuff like that because, you know, the game is brutal. Like, what do you think about this whole Chandler Jones situation being a, you know, former NFL, but you're still an active player? You know what I'm saying?
I feel like a lot of people go through things in life. I feel like a lot of people have answers for people that are going through something that they've never been through.
Yeah.
And we don't know what he's seen. We don't know what he's going through. So you just got to kind of support them. I mean, hopefully they figure out what's going on because, like, I mean, my boy, he's going pretty ham right now.
Yeah.
I just hope that whatever he has going on, he just gets it right because, I don't know, I've been in situations before where people don't know what's going on. They got opinions about what they think is how it's supposed to be, and it's not really like that way. So,
Once we placed him on the non-active list, like, at this point, he's got kind of quiet on social media. So I think they kind of got a grasp of, you know what I mean? Kind of got it under control at this point.
Is he living out here right now?
Yeah.
Let's invite him to the party.
Oh,
that's what he needs.
Come to the party, bro. Look,
bro, he will be tweeting tonight. He will be tweeting like crazy tonight if he had the blackout.
No, because we all safe though. Like, we ain't got no job right now. Like, we ain't got to play.
We would all be canceled. Like, nah.
This is a safe space.
Oh, man.
That's crazy. Hey,
He just needs a night out with the boys.
Hey, Chandler, come kick it with his dad.
Leave your phone at home. Come out with the boys.
Don't press send.
Hey, I want to ask, are you still close with any active players on the team right now?
Who's left?
I know, like, there's not really too many.
A lot of the young cats stay in contact sometimes, but, like, no, I feel like everybody got their own thing going on in life.
Yeah.
So I don't really talk to too many people. But, like, I reach out and tap in with people, like, even on social media.
Mm-hmm.
That's the best way to keep up with somebody. When I see a video or something, I'll be like, oh, hell no, that's funny.
Yeah.
And the next person, oh, that's cool. Or somebody say, I'll help you get well, blah, blah, blah. And then that's my way of staying in contact with them, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, social media makes it easy. It's nice.
Yeah, definitely. How'd that good football, that Good Morning Football interview come together?
It was tight, man. Everybody that works on Good Morning Football usually shows me a lot of love, and I appreciate it. They still think I should still be playing for sure.
Everybody do.
Of course. Yeah. So they just show a lot of love, as much love as they can. And, man, hopefully they bring me back. That'll be fun. Yeah. But, like, New York's a vibe, too.
Hey, Top Beast asked you, Kat, do you think, and we talked about this a little bit in the pod before, do you think that Gruden blackballed you? Why do you think nobody would have picked you up in the prime of your career as a top punter?
I don't think it was up to one person. I think it's the word.
Collective. Yeah.
I tried to use an SAT word.
Or a culmination of things.
Yeah, it's a combination, man. It ain't just one person, but I think it's a combination. And at the same time, like I said, I know who I am as a person, man. And me not playing in the NFL won't break me.
Right.
I know who I am, and I'm happy. I'm happy as hell, but I definitely know for a fact I should still be playing.
100%.
One of the best still.
100%.
I don't know. I used to be shy about saying that, and now I'm like, F it, dog. Like, that's what I am. I'm gonna own it.
And you, what? You only 34 years old, bro.
34,
like,
man.
Yeah, you still got some time. Like, kickers, man. They kick into their 40s.
About 40, 50 years old, man.
Yeah. Like,
right.
Man, yeah. We got to get you. We got to get you active, man. We might have to Make something shake where we can get our guy, AJ Cole.
Change my name, cut my hair a little bit, and then play a different position. Go out for wide out.
Yeah, hey, man. So you're performing at halftime tomorrow, Tucci, right?
Hey, where you at? Yeah. I'm down.
You ain't going to be for the game, right?
Nah, I got a deal. I got to work on some stuff. Music-wise, trying to get like you, man.
Ah, come on. But I want to know, though, are you working on an album, like an EP? What you got going on?
I'm working on an album. I'm looking at dropping it in February when XFL season start.
Mm-hmm.
And I got a couple of shows set up. I actually got to perform in the Bay on October 14th, so that'll be fun.
Going back to the crib, huh?
Heck yeah.
Where
going to the town?
Vallejo.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bros and Sacks, so let us know so you can pull up.
Yep. Oh, yeah, it's going to be at Makers Fair.
Okay.
So it's a technology fair fashion thing, and it's a whole festival, so it's gonna be kind of cool.
Right.
You miss the area out there, man. I know.
Of course, I actually thought I was gonna move out here too.
Yeah.
And then
Right.
But the Bay was actually really nice. Like, I used to love going there at the games. Like, my off day, man, I just catch an Uber XL all the way to the city, just bar hop, ride a little train by myself in the middle of the night, and just vibe, man.
Right.
Shoot the zombies at Pier 39 and stuff.
There's a lot of them.
There's a lot of them.
Hey, shout out to Ishan. He says, Marquette, what was the craziest thing that you've seen a fan do in the stands or at a tailgate? I know Oakland was crazy. You got any stories of any crazy fans?
I'm trying to think, man. I don't know. I have to think about that one because y'all got to remember, like, y'all know who y'all are, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's a lot of crazy things I've seen. I got to think about that one.
you gotta put that one together, man, because, you know, in Oakland, everything's crazy.
Oh, it's going
you know what I mean? So,
I mean, but y'all in Vegas now. This is way worse.
Oh, yeah.
It's different.
In a good way.
It's different.
The chaos is different.
Yeah.
You know, the vibes in Oakland is, I might die out here. Out here in Vegas is, I might die because of the heat. You know what I'm saying? So you can still die, but it's just levels to it.
Like, control chaos.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Hey, what's that? Do you have a title for the album yet?
Man, so my idea was to create an album, and you remember Grand Theft Auto Vice City, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I wanted it to be similar to one of the stations, so I was going to call it KS Kick Squad, KS 107. I wore number 1, I wore number 0, and I wore number 7. So, like,
oh, that's dope.
I'm going to have somebody, you remember Jeanette Thompson from, she used to work with the Raiders?
Yep.
I'm going to have her be the voice, like the lady at the radio station talking as if it's a whole radio station.
Yeah.
And it's just going to, something that people can just hit play and just let it ride.
That's dope. I like that. Funniest moment at practice. Robert wants to know. Any funny moments at practice with a specific teammate?
Man, I'm trying to think. I usually like the teammate. I can't think of the teammate right now, but I like if I get too bored, because y'all know I was by myself most of the time with long snapper. So what I would do is put tape on the back of the football and make it look like a sperm, and I'll punt it as far as I can. It looked like flying sperm in the air.
But there you have it. Hey, we talking about sperm now. This show is going exactly how I wanted it to go.
Hey, and I was even thinking, I was like, man, what if I did this and created a whole video about sex education? It'd be good.
Yo, my man. Hey, salute real quick to Brave also. He wants to say, Mr. King, tell us a Mr. Mark Davis story. You got any interest in Mark Davis story?
Yeah, besides the haircut. Let's see.
I was going to say, do you know his barber yet?
Man, yeah. Oh, I do remember. This is probably why I got cut.
So like, this is going to be great.
We was in Sarasota. Michaela ain't here. Right. We was in Sarasota, and I was vibing out there. Like, it was right after we played the Bills. You know, we had to stay on the East Coast for a week, so we didn't have to fly back to Cali and come back. So we stayed in Sarasota at this hotel, and Jenikowski convinced me to go out somewhere with, So we went out, came back, and we're chilling, and I was kind of lit, you know what I'm saying? So I was kind of lit, and then I was sitting out on the back of the patio, and I had like these two cougars beside me. We were just chilling, talking for a little bit, and then it kind of got a little interesting. Yeah, it kind of got a little interesting, you know what I'm saying? Hey, how you doing? And then I finished talking to them, we all finished hanging out, and then I go back in the room, or in the lobby, and I see Mark Davis. He's like, hey, Marquette, I see you. I'm like, my God, what's up? And I gave him down, and I put him in the head. And then I come like, dude.
Hold on. Bro, you hit him with the noogie?
I gave him a noogie, man. But you know what? You know what, though? He used to tell me about how he used to get treated back in the day, so I was trying to show him a nicer version of that.
Oh, my God.
Because he used to tell me when he used to get taped up to the field goal pole, and they leave him out there the whole time. I'm like, bro, I would never do that to you. So I got let go.
I'll give you a nugget.
So I'll give you a nugget. Damn, let me find out.
You were in the capital of Cougar Town in Sarasota, bro. Like, I lived out there for years, and
Bass
is nice out there.
I think Bass is still out there.
No, he's in Jacksonville.
Okay, he's in Florida, though. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because, yeah, Stu
was
saying that the Bass is still Bass.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Because he doesn't come to the alumni parties. So, like, everybody has so many questions. He was going to come this year, but something happened where he just couldn't do it. Like some family stuff or something like that. I would love to get Bass on the show.
It'd be funny, man. Just make sure you got a whole thing of vodka right there.
Let me see. Marquette, how did you end up? Well, you know what, Top? I'm not going to ask that question. You'll get that answer on Blackout, on our Blackout podcast. There literally, we just talked about it. So, Top, you will definitely get that answer, brother.
Go subscribe, Blackout Network.
Blackout Network on YouTube, you guys. Let me see. He said, Gru and Mark Davis hung out at the strip club last Tuesday night.
Man.
Did you see that rumor, Cody?
This is a dangerous podcast.
Oh, no, it is. Yeah, it is.
Yeah, I did see the rumor. And what was it about again?
They had a meeting behind closed doors on a Tuesday, I believe, or something like that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's cap. I don't believe it.
Well, I got two opinions. I don't think it's true. But if it ended up being true, I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah.
Wait, what is this rumor?
That Mark Davis and John Gruden had a meeting the other day on Tuesday behind closed doors. And
out here in Las Vegas.
In Vegas. They don't know what it was about. Assuming.
Ultimately, I would assume that it's about, you know, his lawsuit against the NFL, right?
Yeah, I mean, John Gruden has a huge lawsuit against him. But Mark likes to hang out with his guys. So this could have been a cigar. Cody, you know, you're always at the eight. Like Mark is always there.
Always there.
He's kicking it with the guys and the team. Like, so he could have just been having a, you know. But I mean, he's an owner, man. Behind closed
doors. Having a what?
You know what? Hey, John Gruden was giving Mark Davis a swirly, you guys. That's what's going on. Kent got the noogie. John Gruden gave him a swirly.
That's why I should have been at the meeting, too.
Yo, David wants to ask you, man, and we kind of talked about this a little bit. Any Marshawn Lynch story?
I can't think at the moment. I think... Yeah, I can't think at the moment. Not that I know of.
You were there for the moment, the Jets game. the sideline, right?
Yeah, when he was dancing.
Like what was that? Because Oakland, was the man, Oakland's own. Like that made us, like growing up there in Oco. Like I know you like seen that and was like, oh my god, bro. Like, this should have been happening. Like Marshawn should have been a Raider forever. Right. Yeah. You know what I mean? That was the
too late.
What was the vibe at Oco that day?
No, like, it was. Bro, that was the vibe. That was the day to be there, 100%. Because he actually got everybody hyped on the sideline because he don't ever move like that for real.
Yeah.
Like, he just juking most of the time. You start doing all that right there.
Yeah.
Right. I was like, man.
And then we go play the Commanders not too much long later, and we just have a total collapse.
Next.
That was
topic.
A wild game. That was a wild game.
Was all that stuff real?
That was a game that everybody season. Sat down, right?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
yeah.
a good.
Yeah, I remember that one.
Yeah, was all that stuff real with Del Rio and then the whole – kneeling and the Donald Penn stuff, like take us into that game because the whole rumor was, and we were talking about rumors on the last pod, was that everybody kind of bought into the narrative that DC didn't ride with his teammates and Del Rio or something. What was
of course, the blame was always going to be, it's always Derek
Carr's
fault.
Yeah.
But it was that the locker room and the coaching staff weren't on the same page.
Yeah.
I mean, if it was anything going on, I didn't know. Like, I was working on beats, man.
Right.
Working on my hits. Yeah. But like at the same time, like everybody, I can tell I'm really good at reading vibes, and I didn't feel like nothing was off like that.
Yeah.
If anything, everybody got pissed off at whoever the girl was that was brought up, that was bringing that rumor up on whatever radio station they were talking about it on.
Right. Cause Penn tried to kill it immediately. Penn was like, it wasn't true. Yeah. But we seen like all the air just go out of that team after that game. So it was kind of like we were kind of believing it because we're like, what happened? Something happened.
I think everybody was distracted by the comments made by Donald Trump. And we put so much more energy into, we're going to prove our point by doing this or that.
Yeah.
To where we just kind of lost focus. I don't know.
Yeah, it was just so weird. Like after that week, everything
changed.
Those first
two games were like we were coming out hot, and then all of a sudden after that game, it was just.
It's because the offensive line had a bad game. At that time, it was a dominant offensive line. Offensive line has a bad game.
Yeah.
And everyone just thinks like, oh, they did it on purpose. Like they're just like opening the door and go hit the quarterback.
And I talked to Penn myself at the alumni, and that was never the case. He was like, we're gonna go to battle for DC every week.
It's another situation like what you know we just talked to him about on the interview. It's just like there's this media perception. And what they want everyone to think happen.
Yeah.
And then
they're
there's
trying
the
to
truth.
Control a weird narrative.
Yeah. M85 said, did Del Rio
click,
lose
click,
the
click,
team?
Click, 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 click.
I don't think so. I've always had respect from Del Rio, man. He always showed love to me. He always checked on me and my family and everything. He also kept it a buck, especially with me. Like, even with the so-called, the personal fouls, whatever I had. Like,
whatever that was.
I remember the one time he was like, hey, look, like I was walking on the bus. And I think it's worse when you lose a game, but like, walk on the bus, he was like, no more, no more. I'm like, all right, coach. Man, but.
Did you get any of that in 2016 when we went 12-4? Because Raiders fans say right here, like, how did it feel to go from that in 2016 to that playoff appearance where, dang, if Derek didn't break his, man, dog, I really
know. That was like watching the Lion King movie when Simba.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, man, that sucked.
He was having an MVP year.
Yeah.
I mean.
Like, he was killing it, man.
Yeah.
He was murdering the whole
thing. No, that was a fun year, man. I ain't going to lie, too. That was a long, football's a long season, bro.
Yeah.
Like, because imagine, like, kicking 2 to 3 times a week and then kicking in the game. People don't understand, but, like, that's a different kind of workout, man. Like, my leg get tired. Man, so it was almost like swinging a wet rag in a playoff game, like, for me.
And that leg was all pro that year.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
You know what I'm saying? So, but that Houston game, like, did you feel like with DC not there having Connor Cook at the quarterback spot? Like, did everybody feel it? Like, we already know what we're getting ourselves in. Like, we're going to be out of here.
I mean, you always go in the game thinking that you got a chance.
Yeah.
You know, and hoping that they did everything that they could do in their power to be the best version of themselves at that position.
Yeah.
Correct. I don't even remember the score. What was the score?
It was ugly. I know Jadeveon Clowney.
I just know that was the most amount of times I ever punted a ball in a game. I never punted 12 times in a game. Nah, and I got smacked at the end of the game. And I'm like, bro, it's time to go to the crib. It's time to go, man.
He's like, it's off season time. So fuck this.
Yo, heck yeah.
That is hilarious. Like, so with you, you had Derek there. And I don't want to make this a Derek Carr show, but you know. Cody's a New Orleans fan.
Anchor,
you know what I'm saying?
And there's no Saints in Sin City.
You know,
the new model.
No, but I want to, because even with me, I've been very tough on DC. And everybody knows that. Like, the first 7 years, I was behind DC. The past 2 years, I'm like, it's time to move on. And I was happy we did. Don't get me wrong, Jimmy G's not the greatest option. No, he's a but bitch. But at the end of the day, we moved on, and now he's somewhere winning. It's better for him. We're moved on. But like, a lot of people try to question his leadership. You know what I'm saying? Like, where were you in terms with D? I know you said that was your guy. Like, was he a real leader in that locker room?
I think he led the locker room pretty well. He did what he had to do to get everybody on one accord. And shoot, man, he just did what he had to do as a quarterback. He handled that role really, really good.
Yeah. I know you said that's your guy.
That's so, my guy.
Yeah.
I mean, for me, I got a whole different routine, man. I make sure I don't do the same stuff all the time. A lot of kickers and punters are superstitious, and I purposely do something different all the time to make sure I don't put myself in that weird position where if I don't do that this day, I'm off.
Yeah. So, this is a great question right here that Martin got for King as well. Fans cry about we need a better defense. We've needed a defense forever. Mm-hmm. Like, does that feeling like from outside ever affect the locker room? Like, do you guys hear the noise? Like, does the defense feel that? You know what I mean? Like,
oh, yeah, 100%. You can tell when offense and defense is off. Like, yeah. When I was there, I don't know who was balling at the time. Was offense or defense killing it? When I was
the
there.
O, the it was O, offense. 2016, the O was exceptional. Yeah. The defense was cool, but we had Khalil, we had Bruce Irvin.
Yeah.
So the defense was cool, but it was like, I don't want to say a bend don't break defense, but like they did enough. But the O was
crazy. Nah, you can feel it. It's almost like I don't know. It's almost like you ever hung around your girl before, and she make you feel like you did something wrong. She ain't even got to say nothing. She just quiet.
Yeah,
that's about how I feel.
And it's hella funny.
We're all like, man, that's rough.
Because Kat's girl is on the other side of the wall right now. So it's hella funny. That shit is hella funny.
And she can hear.
Yeah.
By the way.
Everything.
That's right.
And she can be. And she can literally beat up every one of us in this room.
Hey, look, I'm still a professional kicker though. So like, come on now.
Don't walk out the door. Yo, no, we got a
fuck
few.
Up, right?
We got a few more minutes, you guys, before we got to get out of here and head over to our next gig, man. Make sure you guys put a few questions in there. Let's have some fun while we're here, man. Once again, salute to Blue Wire, man, for having us. You know what I mean? Salute to our Blackout family, man. We love what we do, man. For us to be able to be passionate fans and turn this into something like this, it's crazy, right? So I just want to say, man, salute to everybody that was a part of what we got going on over here. Salute to our brother Barco, you know, Cody and everybody else, man. Let's talk real quick, briefly, because we have a game tomorrow. Right, and we didn't even mention the game once in these two episodes. How are y'all feeling, really, Cody, going in tomorrow? Like a score wise, we talked a little bit, but how do you feel score wise? Like, we're gonna do a prediction, bro. We have to.
Yeah.
What you got?
I think it's a high scoring game.
Ooh, okay, but yeah. Pittsburgh's offense has struggled all year long.
Yeah.
But every team that struggles always finds their way against us.
Yeah, it's always a different, you know, always a different narrative whenever we're playing on the field. So I think it's a high scoring game, and we're going to see what this team's about. I feel like it's too many times we talk about throughout the season.
Yeah.
How are we going to bounce back? This is a bounce back game. If we don't, then we're just going to lose our traction for the rest of the year. Home opener, big time, Lil Wayne performing. At some point, I mean, we're getting Jacoby Myers back, Devonta Adams.
Thank goodness, he's still good. You didn't mention Jordan Sparks' beautiful ass.
Oh, yes.
Singing the national anthem tomorrow.
Kicking it off.
You know what I'm saying? That's another rock star right there. Kat,
uh-oh.
I mean, you know what I mean?
Uh-oh. Money to stay.
Nah, but score-wise, what you got?
I'm going to go 32-28.
Raiders. Okay. What you got, Hammer? And give us a little intel on what you got. Because I know Hammer, he breaks these games down to a T. What you got?
Nationally televised under the lights. It couldn't be a better game for them, especially our homecoming.
Yeah.
Definitely a high-scoring game. I'm still under the suspicion right now that Pickett is going to have 2, maybe 3 turnovers in this game.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. I'm here for it. Trust me.
For a team that doesn't have one yet, that I would love it.
Right? Yeah. Jacobs, week 3, we're knocking the rust off now. I think we're going to see him go for about buck 25 rushing.
I'd love that.
I want to see Tay and Jacoby get at least 1 touchdown each. I want to see our tight ends involved, and I want to see that red zone offense really wake up. Defensively, interior D-line has to show up.
It has to. Bro.
I love our linebackers right now. Our linebackers right now, Spillane and Diablo, have done a really solid job the first 2 games. That interior has to step up. They have to shut down Najee Harris. They got to apply the pressure to force those turnovers. 31-17, Raiders.
Ooh.
Let's go.
You know what? I agree with you. I'm going 31-17. I'm just going to steal your shit.
Let's go.
What you got, B?
I'm going 27-24 Raiders.
Okay, close game. Kick Daniel Carlson for the game? Prime time?
I mean.
From 55.
From 55.
I like that. I like that. Now, Kat, I know you know, you keep up with the game, but I know you don't, you know, you're a rock star, bro. You ain't got too much, you know what I mean? Like, but former Raider, you know what I mean? Still heavily involved, you know, in football. What do you got tomorrow with the Raiders and Steelers?
Man, like I said, I pick up on the vibes. I've heard a couple of things about this coach that y'all have. He came from where?
New England.
New England?
Yeah, Josh McDaniels.
So I think what he needs to do is let these players feed into what the Raiders are really about. If you don't let these players be what the Raiders truly are, what they stand for, let them be themselves and he tries to keep everybody straight and acting in a certain type of way, yeah. I feel like it'll be kind of rough.
So basically, the Patriot way ain't gonna work here.
I don't know because it's not what y'all stand for, y'all. Come on now.
We don't need the Patriot way.
That's what I'm
saying.
Come
up with a Raider way.
Let everybody be themselves and let everybody live life and have fun on the field because it's a game, and then y'all will be all right. And I think if he let them go, let them have fun, let them loose, y'all will be good.
We're 1-1 right now. Give us just you don't even no score. Who's winning tomorrow?
Yeah, that's a hard question. I haven't watched no football since the Deion Sanders game last weekend. Like, that's the first time.
Kat said the Raiders. He just said it.
Okay. Raiders. Yeah, Raiders. Kat okay. Said it, I was about to leave if he said
Steelers. I'm not going to say Steelers. I mean, but I like to give honest answers, you know?
Yeah, that's all love. That's why we love you, Kat. We already know we're going to get the real. You already know. Cody, I know you love the game. One thing about Cody, fantasy, he does all of it. So you watch every game. You own one of the dopest sports bars in Las Vegas. What do you got tomorrow with this game? And I know you're going to be there front and center, drunk as shit.
No, first off, instead of the score, tell us how many burgers we're going to eat tomorrow. That's what I want to know.
What's the over-under on that? We got six right here, so I'll take the over all day on that. But, no, I do think it's going to be a close game. I think the prime time is going to be a big deal. I do say it's going to be a Carlson game winner. So I'm going to go 31-28.
I like that.
Woo.
Okay. I like that.
Raiders.
Raiders. There we go. Shout out to everybody here in the building, man. We appreciate you guys as always. You guys know I'm out of town, so I've not been able to do too much content. It's kind of tough doing it on the road. So
we creating content.
We creating. You know what I mean? So, but salute to everybody. I will be back. You know what? I'll probably do a live from the room tomorrow after the game. You know what I mean? Kind of do that. And then I'll be back in Dallas Monday. If we, especially if we win. You know, if we lose, you're gonna get a bad version of myself. So
Tuesday.
But,
Tuesday. Wait, you're doing the Wynn Field after party with us, right?
Oh yeah.
So, y'all tune in for that show.
We're gonna go live in there. That's gonna be
absolutely Tuesday night, because I'll be back on the East Coast.
Yeah.
Me and Graf will be live. Beast and Best, Raiders Talk Live, our call-in show.
Yep.
Guys, pull on up to that. You know, we've been having a lot of fun doing that this last month and a half. And look, that show doesn't run unless you guys get involved. So make sure to call into the SeatGeek Vault line and let's have some fun Tuesday night, yo.
Salute. Shout out to everybody here in the building. We're about to go get very drunk. Real quick, before we do that, I want everybody to just kind of plug where you are. This is my brother right here. He don't really do too much social media. But we do have something in the works right now that is very dope. So I want you guys to know, a lot of people ask, where's B at, right? B is always working behind the scenes doing
B's
stuff.
B's right there.
Yeah. Well, you know what I mean? But he's very active with behind the scenes work. Let's just say that. So Cody, man, where can everybody follow the podcast that we just did right before this?
Blackout Network on YouTube. Where's my camera? There it is over there. Blackout Network on YouTube. Blackoutdivision.com has all of our links and all of our events. You can watch us on YouTube, but I suggest you come out to Vegas and just kick it with us first.
Yeah, there you go. Real quick, Hammer, man, let them know where they can follow you at, bro.
Raider Nation News today, we're 31 hours away from kickoff, right? Everybody in here today, subscribe to Raider Nation News today. We can be at 7K. Come kickoff tomorrow.
There you
go. Let's get it running, y'all.
There you go. Run my brother's channel up. Real quick, Kat, man, let them know where they can follow your music, where they can follow you at, because I'm excited about the new music, man.
Hey, look, man, I know y'all ready for that game tomorrow. Look, go to Spotify, Apple Music, all platforms. Check out Marquette King, whatever one. Look, follow me on Marquette King. It's either or. And look, just have a great day today.
There you
go. This weekend. Let's go.
Vibes, bro.
It's dub.
Vibes. Cody, man, let them know where the restaurant is. You got a lot going on. So just let the chat know everything you got going on right now, bro.
Yeah, you can catch me at Barco Burgers pretty much every day. We're at 1590 East Flamingo. My personal is Barco Cody, Barco Burgers on IG. And let's get over to daylight. Let's see if we can get Marquette on stage, bro.
Let's do it.
Hey, if y'all ready for that, man, let me do some push-ups.
Salute to everybody here in the building, man. Shout out to our brother Kett for kicking it with us, you know, for the podcast today, man. Salute. Salute to everybody also in the building. You already know what I'm going to say, what I always say. Wipe them feet, meaning hit them thumbs up. Also hit that subscribe button. OakLasVegas.com for the drip. PlanetRaiders.com for everything. And you already know what it is, man. Blackout. Salute to y'all. We love y'all. We out.